So now let's discuss the second question. And the question is, a binary system of species 1 and 2 consists of vapor and liquid phase in equilibrium at temperature T, for which ln gamma 1 is equal to 1.8 x2 square, ln gamma 2 is equal to 1.8 x1 square, P1 saturated is 1.24 bar and P2 saturated is 0.89 bar. Assuming the validity of Raoult's law, so first we need to determine for what range of values of overall mole fraction Z1 can this two-phase system exist with a liquid mole fraction X1 is equal to 0.65. So let's start. And the second part is, what is the pressure P and vapor mole fraction Y1 within this range? Okay, so these two are correlated, that you can see over here. So what is given to us is P1S is given, which is 1.24 bar, and P2S is 0.89 bar. Okay, and X1 here is given, which is 0.65. So X2 is 0.35. So with the help of these two, you can substitute these values into the given activity coefficient relation. So you will get value of ln gamma, directly gamma 1 and gamma 2, which is 1.25, and gamma 2 is 2.154. Now we know that total pressure is equals to x1 gamma 1 p1s plus x2 gamma 2 p2s. So now we have all the values, substitute all the values, and then you will get value of total pressure, which comes 1.673 bar. And we know that y1 is equals to x1 gamma 1 p1s, this is gamma, upon total pressure. So when now we have all these value, we have total pressure, gamma 1 x1 p1s, substitute the values and we get 6.602. so this is the answer of total pressure B for the second part. So total pressure is 1.673 and the mole fraction y1 vapor phase is 0.607. Now we need to find out for what range of values of overall mole fraction z1 can this two phase system exist. Okay, x1 is given to us, so by a material balance, we know that L plus V is equals to 1. So L is equals to 1 minus V, and component balance is YI V. So ZI is equals to XI. In place of L, we can substitute 1 minus V plus YI V. So rearrange this. XI, V is common here, YI minus XI. So V is equals to ZI minus XI, YI minus XI. So range for V in the vapor phase, what will be the range? Kya range ho sakti hai? So we know that that will be minimum is 0 and maximum is 1. So V lies between 0 to 1. So and we have the value of xi and yi. So xi is, it's given 0.65, and yi humne bhi just calculate kiya, which comes 0.602. So you can substitute into this. So you will get 0. Zi is remain same. This is 0.65. Here it is 0.602 minus 0.65. So value of zi is 0.602. And the secondary, when you put Z, V is equals to 1, so Zi is equal to 0.65. So the range of overall mole fraction is lies between 0.602 Zi to 0.65. So this is the answer of your first question. Now let's discuss the third part. What are the pressure and composition of the azeotrope at temperature T? So azeotropic calculation. third part. Okay. So here what we do, we know that y adiotrope means y adiotrope is equals to x adiotrope, mole fraction is same at adiotropes. So here what we do, we just assume the value of x1, jaise humne previous question mein kiya tha. So you just assume the question, you just assume the value of x, and the x we know that it lies between 0 to 1. So you can assume anything, because hamara jo x1 hai wo kitna aaya tha, 0.6. So let's 0.65 given hai. So let's assume 0.6, okay? And then we can find out if x1 is 0.6, so we just assume x1 0.6, and you can assume anything between 0 to 1. Aap kuch bhi assume kar sakte ho. Fir se iteration method hai. Jab tak wo converge nahi ho jata, you have to do the iteration. Aur jaise hi wo converge ho jayega, you will get the final answer. So yahan par maine, kyunki x1 humko 0.65 given tha, to isliye uske nearby maine value le li. And x2 kya ho jayega, 0.4. Then you substitute x1 and x2 values in the given activity coefficient relationship. So you will get gamma 1 and gamma 2. So gamma 1 is equals to exponential of 1.8 x2 square and gamma 2. So this is 1.33, and gamma 2 is exponential of 1.8 x1 square. You just substitute values 1.912. So these are the two values of gamma 1 and gamma 2. Now we know that P is equals to same steps hai, jo humne pehle kiye the. So just find out the total pressure. So we know this relation. You can just substitute all these values. You will get the pressure 1.67 bar. Then Y1 is x1 gamma 1 p1 s upon p. Now you have all these values. So gamma y1 yahan par kitna aata hai, it comes 0.592, and we know that y1 at this temperature the adiotropes form ho rahe hain. So y1 is equals to x1 adiotrope. These are the two adiotropes. Now these are the values. Again, because we are not confirmed yet, तो आप क्या करोगे, अगेन आप फिर से इसी में न्यू x1 एंड x2 मिल गया आपको. सो x1 इज 0.592 और x2 क्या हो जाएगा, 1 माइनस 0.592 विच इज इक्वल्स टू 0.407. अगेन सब्सटीट्यूट दिस वैल्यू इनटू दिस गिवन एक्टिविटी रिलेशन. सो गामा 1 यहाँ से आता है, गामा 1 इज 1.347, गामा 2 ये आता 1.879. अगेन सब्स्टिट्यूट, अगेन यू जस्ट नीड टू रिपीट द स्टेप्स. सो जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट ऑल दिस वैल्यू इनटू द टोटल प्रेशर रिलेशन. सो पी इट कम्स 1.67 बार. सो यहाँ से अब ये सेम हो गया, चेंज नहीं हो रहा है. दैट मींस आपके जो फाइनल वैल्यू है वो क्या होगी, यही जो होगी, दैट इज द योर फाइनल आंसर. ठीक है, वो रिपीट होना उसने चेंज होना बंद कर दिया. इट इज नाउ सेम, रिमेन सेम. एंड देन y1 अगेन सब्स्टिट्यूट ऑल दिस वैल्यू हियर, सो इट इज 0.592, और x1 भी क्या हो जाएगा, 0.592. सो दीज आर द टू वैल्यूज ऑफ एजिट्रॉप्स, एंड दिस इज द टोटल प्रेशर 1.67 बार. सो क्वेश्चंस बहुत इजी है, सेम फॉर्मूलाज है, बट आपको सिर्फ उनको इटरेशंस करना है, रिपीट करना है स्टेप्स को. और जब तक वो कन्वर्ज नहीं हो जाता, जब तक आपको सेम आंसर्स नहीं मिलने लग जाते, तब तक आपको सॉल्व करते जाना है.